I know that the phrase sentinel chickens does sound a bit ridiculous. These chickens here in Griffith in rural Australia are not keeping watch for anything. They're not on guard. They are just chickens. But they are helping keep folks in this area of New South Wales safe from some nasty diseases. Diseases like Murray Valley Encephalitis, MVE. It infects animals, including humans, and it's carried by mosquitoes. It has no vaccine, no cure. Most people who get it will suffer fever and nausea, but about 1 in 1,000 will get seriously ill, with a chance of life-changing brain injuries or death. If that virus is starting to flare up in the animal population around here, mosquito transmission means it can easily spread to humans. So it'd be really useful for the local health department to have an early warning system.
We have 8 flocks at the moment, and there are 15 birds per flock. They are usually between 9 and 14 weeks old when we get them at the start of the season. They are fed, watered, and they lay eggs. And that's an additional bonus for the person that's looking after our coop. They get to keep the eggs.
Ideally, the researchers would track levels of the virus in wild animals and birds. That's where it thrives. But that plan involves catching and testing wild animals. Not practical. So instead, chickens. They don't get sick from MVE or other diseases like it, and they can't pass it on either. But if they get infected, their immune system still fights. It still creates antibodies. The technical term is seroconversion. And these chickens are outside every hour of every day, and the mosquitoes will bite them a lot.
We take a small amount of blood from each chicken weekly. They collect the chickens, and then we do a bleeding process where they take a small amount of blood via a lancet from under the wing, collected on a small blotting strip. It's just a very small pinprick. Chickens have a leg band on so that we know very specifically what bird and what sample, and we can match them up. And that goes off to our labs in Sydney, where they do a number of tests for a whole range of mosquito-borne viruses. The mosquito levels are important as well, but it's not enough just to track mosquitoes. It's important that we monitor a reservoir that can give us a better indication quicker. The chickens give us a pretty early warning within a couple of weeks. If we saw seroconversions in our flocks, we would ramp up the local media to get that message out, use a repellent, not be outside at dawn and dusk, and wear light, loose-fitting clothing. Camping groups, fishing groups, those people that are visiting areas, get the message as well. We will provide information to local GPs so that they will be looking for symptoms, and there are other flocks in other countries, I'm sure, as part of their surveillance program.
Of course, once a chicken is tested positive, its work is done. It will always have those antibodies. It will always test positive. So at that point, it is retired, and I am assured that's not a euphemism, and testing continues on the rest of the flock. I was a bit worried about animal safety and cruelty here, but do you mind? The chickens are well cared for. They're just having a blood sample taken occasionally. In a world with factory farming and fried chicken shops, this does seem fairly low down on the scale of things humanity does to chickens.
We really have no other way of knowing what virus might be around in the area, and they do save lives.
Never work with animals. But this is not food. These are my fingers.